Hello everyone, so in today's little vlog, I'll be taking a drive in using GetGo's car sharing service. So for those of you guys that don't know, GetGo is not the largest car sharing service in Singapore. It's a point A to point A service, which means that you've got to return the car back to where you found it. So you know, there happens to be a Toyota Sienta, which is a hybrid car, you know, in my area in Jurong. So I'll be taking a drive and letting you guys see how the experience is like. So upon first impressions, you know, I mean, the car looks relatively well maintained. I mean, I don't see any falling lights or whatever, although there is to be expected a bit of cosmetic defects. So perhaps, you know, some user scratched the car against it or something. But, you know, I shall unlock this car and show you guys perhaps how the car sharing service is. So let's take a ride in it and let's go. Alright, so now we have the car open, so let's take a look. Overall, it looks pretty clean, so you can see the seats, you know, are these very nice sort of cloth seats. And we don't really see, you know, much stains or anything. I mean, there are a bit of grass or the carpet, but overall, you know, the seats is pretty clean. Okay, so I got the car, you know, started up. So everything seems to be working fine, except the petrol seems to be a bit low. So let's see if we need to make a refuel later. But other than that, yeah, everything seems to be doing fine. The radio works, everything seems to work. So let's see how the drive goes. Okay, so it's nighttime now and I'm still driving the Sienta. So you guys can see, you know, went for like a romantic drive down the CBD area. It's something you can do, I guess, when you have the car for the weekend. So overall, you know, this is an MPV from GetGo. I wouldn't this would not necessarily be my first choice for a car, but this is a 7-seater, so you know, if you are family to ferry around, it does the job well, just without any soul. But so far, I haven't had any, you know, major issues, you know, driving this car. Like I said, I've literally driven it from dusk till dawn so far. The only one thing to know is that if you are driving a Toyota Sienta, you know, I forgot to release a foot brake at the start, which led to some warning lights. So it took me a while to figure it out. So do know that as compared to a sedan or an SUV, you know, you need to release a foot brake first. But yeah, overall, yeah, it's been a pleasant drive. The car is generally clean and everything in it works. Okay, so for today, I'll be trying the Mazda 3 car instead. So let's see how it rides the sedan as compared to the MPV Toyota Sienta. Okay, so I'm on the interior of the Mazda 3. It looks pretty modern, I think slightly more modern than the Toyota Sienta. So that's my stuff. So as you can see, it's pretty, it's pretty clean. Of course, there's a bit of wear and tear, but it's pretty clean throughout, at least here on the driver's seat and what I can see in my back seat. Let's try starting out the car. Okay, you hear the aircon coming on. Yeah, so everything works. So let me take this for a drive and I'll write about my experiences. Alright, so now I'm in the Mazda 3. Here in GetGo. Overall, I'll say definitely the Mazda 3 is stronger, more powerful, easier to drive than the Toyota Sienta. You know, Toyota Sienta is sort of like a machine, you know, so you know, if you like to drive, your affinity with cars, you know, the driving experience, definitely the Mazda 3 driving experience is much better, you know, and there's a sunroof as well, so you know, if you're out on a date or what, you know, the view is better, the interior feels more modern, and it's a sedan, right? It just generally looks better. Yeah, I really much prefer driving the Mazda 3 as compared to the Toyota Sienta. I think personally for me, it feels more well maintained, so I didn't really face any issues with the condition of the Mazda 3. The driving experience pretty much was smooth sailing, and yeah, I really enjoyed my drive. You know, it really did make me feel a bit like a driver, which I guess is what people rent cars for. Okay, so in conclusion, you know, I definitely, you know, enjoyed my GetGo car sharing experience. I think what I enjoyed most about the experience was the user friendliness of the interface and the entire experience, actually. So, you know, unlike, you know, other car sharing apps or platforms where you have to put a deposit or pay like a monthly fee, you know, there's no such thing in GetGo, right? I think the only fee that you pay is hourly rental as well as the mileage charge. So it's really pay per use, there's no fixed cost to it. And I really appreciate that it made it more affordable, so it made it easier to plan. And you know, I really do like the fact that you can make bookings in advance. I could make bookings a week in advance for the car that I desire and the car park that I desire. So yeah, that's a great, you know, touch, I think, in the interface. And the 24-hour live support is a good touch too, you know. I have tried some other car sharing platforms and the live support is a little touch and go, but with GetGo, everything, you know, went smoothly. So yeah, I'm pleased to say that I enjoyed, you know, both my Toyota Sienta and Mazda 3 experience. Although if I had to pick, definitely I enjoyed driving the Mazda 3 more, although that's more than the car. But yeah, I can see if you're a big family, I think the Toyota Sienta makes a lot of sense. Okay, so if you're interested in signing up for GetGo as well, GetGo has kind of provided my videos with a promo code. So you can use the promo code below, which I believe is WSS8OFF, for 50% off your first ride, cap at $8. So yeah, just go have some fun, you know. Sign up takes like a few minutes. Why not? I really, you don't need to be rich to own a car, I guess. I want to push it about, you know, GetGo is a really made car sharing, or the fact of driving, the driving experience, affordable and accessible to anyone. Alright, and that rounds up, you know, this video for today. I hope you sort of enjoy sort of this me branching out into more lifestyle, you know, topics or brands, I suppose. And yeah, this will hopefully be a direction moving forward into 2021. Or rather 2022, as I'm filming this, this is 2021, yeah. And I believe this will be out during Christmas, so happy Merry Christmas to everyone watching this as well. As always, if you like the video, you know, to subscribe, to share around. I'll see you guys in my next video. Ciao!